fans, Wyf CaityB back in the building with another reaction video with Mama B. This is my mama and we only react to polys or just Nisians in general. So for today we're reacting to the bro CG Fez. My brother here is half Turkish and what, Mama B?
Tongan.
Mm-hmm. Merhaba.
Günaydın.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're full Turkish now. Mm. Just because we watch Turkish Akkas.
York.
Abla. But yeah, yeah, I just thought I'll show off some more. Hey, Annie.
Kızım.
What does that mean?
Daughter.
Oh. Okay, but yeah, fams, so we're reacting to CG Fizz and his track is called 4:30. 4:30 in the morning, 4:30 end of the year.
So we've done take one.
Yep, and take two.
Two, now yep. 4:30.
So yeah guys, if you're new to our channel and this is the first ever video you're watching, welcome to our channel. And thank you so much for stopping by, and if you want to consider subscribing, please do by clicking on my logo over there or click subscribe at the bottom, and please don't forget to click that bell to keep notified when we upload videos for you guys. So yeah. Okay, don't forget fams, PolyMovement, PolyBusinesses. Today Mumbi, what are we wearing?
Uche Apparel. Brother's from Sydney, but he resides in Brisbane now.
Yeah.
So please check him out.
So he has an online website where you can purchase gears. You can also DM him. But yeah, it's probably preferable that you guys go online through the website. It's more easier for him to keep track on what's going on and what needs to come through with orders. And he does have other, you know, new designs on the website that you guys can check out, and colours as well.
And children's sizes too.
Yeah, baby. Yeah, fams, thank you to those that have requested, and let's get into the track.
I like this guy's drive. I like the way he raps.
Like
in take one, take two, it was more relatable. He was more vulnerable. But it was
take
deep.
Two was definitely my favorite.
Yeah.
His demeanor, you know what I mean?
Yeah, so let's go check this one. What does 4:30 mean? Let's go.
Hey.
Oh, for a second I thought that was DJ Khaled. Wait, sorry. Give me a little heart attack for a second.
Nah. Us Polly's were spunkier than that.
Yeah, I know. DJ Khaled's trying to copy CG Fez, you know? Feels deep already.
Don't stop. Okay, sorry. I want to feel it. 5 minutes, come on.
Hey. Fuck. Hey. Waking up to hot sweats at 4:30 in the morning, gripping on my chest to feel the beating of my organs, breathing real distorted. Should I take this as a warning from the alcohol I'm pouring to the lines I keep on calling while I'm looking for a reason I should stay alive, trying to find some trees when I'm staring at the moon, head spinning round, and I always stay awake at night when they see me in dreams. It means death is coming soon. It means death is on the way from the barrel to the blade. These calculated restraints keep me from finding a cage, but it's fuck, cause they took my bigger bro to the prison end. That's the only way this road leads. When the end is always close, danger imminent. You can move vigilant, but in a sense is equivalent as home to an immigrant. You can lose respect in truckloads, but you only earn it back in minor increments. And that's the kind of shit that turns kids to choose a blade over instruments. Morals and significance, so show me you're legitimate when taking trips. They think I'm talking about a rapper when I mention CB and how we're taking risks. Bring out your star, play out and watch us circle him like Satanists. Definition of a backwards cop like atheist. This blade's low maintenance. Try and find a home in Homo sapiens. Stuck on trying to work on a father flipping packs. I guess I'm to a love of wildlife conservationists. And nah, fuck, I'm good. Fuck. Hey, I'm waking up to hot sweats at 4:30 in the morning. Feeling like the handy might have got me too faded. Hear my ringtone and think my baby mama's calling.
He's letting it out. Now, mate, we got you.
Yeah, this definitely feels like take two. I think this is more deeper version of, you know, it's more. I feel like he's sort of getting deeper every time he drops a track.
I guess everybody deals with it differently.
Yeah.
Some similar, you know, but we need to reach out. We need to
communicate.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
100%.
Damn. And what a good way to, you know, release it through music. You know, music's like food for the soul type of thing, so
yeah.
It's good to let it out.
Yeah.
And yeah, music's like a good way for people to understand you as well, to really reach into a person's soul. See, like, you, as soon as the song started, I already felt it, you know, with the beat that he chose, how he started off and how he's rapping and stuff. Increments, though, that's the first time I've ever heard that word.
And small branches.
Yeah, small, but yeah, I've, yeah.
The 2-for-1 reference could maybe be the reason that my next sentence could be my death sentence. See, this money isn't shit, but the value in my mind is what I'll leave for my kids, and that's the best presents. And to my daughters, if you're listening, just know that what it's come to. Every night I wish that I could hug you. Every night I wish that I could tuck you into bed, squeeze tight before you sleep, and tell your baby daddy loves you. Tell your daddy wishes he could see you in the morning when you're smiling and your hair's all naughty from your sleep. But me and your mom have got some issues, hurting on how I miss you, but the pain we both feel is too deep. Pain we both feel is too deep. Pain we both feel is too fucking deep. Hey. For 5 years, man, we had it all. For 5 years, we had a ball, from that glance at basketball to romance inside of the walls of university. If I'm speaking on a D, it's kinda hurting me. It brings tears to this young poetic face. Of any case, hold any hate I had, now watch it blow away. Had a dream, we stayed together to them golden gates. I had Sydney on my chest, you were my lowest lane. But I keep thinking about your smile and your soft lip kisses, knowing that I lost me a winner. I know I'm looking deep into the eyes of adversity, but trying to save me a sinner just might make me a sinner. I'm just trying to break the chains of confinement. Speaking while staying silent, like speeding without a license. Reaching the deepest climate, too cohesive with my writing. But at the same time, I break the chains on our assignments.
Damn.
It's very detailed.
Damn, yeah.
Very.
He's not holding anything back,
no,
in the scene,
yeah.
See? And seeing the chains on his legs sort of spreads a message too, eh? Like, type of thing. Damn.
And I know. I feel like he's past this, he's been through it, but he's just, the awareness he's putting out there is so deep.
And,
nice, and he's acknowledging, you know,
his
mistakes,
that,
you know,
it's
where,
not everything's perfect,
where things went wrong, his children.
Yeah. His, you know, his demeanour, just because he looks a certain way doesn't mean that he's not going through his battles.
Yeah.
Like, that goes for everyone, you know, they might look intimidating and, you know, hard to talk to and stuff like that, but they're definitely going through their struggles.
Yeah.
And I'm guessing 4:30 must be like early thoughts.
No, it's a recurrence for him. 4:30 seems to wake up at that
certain time.
And it's a dream, it's a pattern that's he's recognising. Like, even though, like, there'll be times where you can get real drunk off your face, or maybe stoned off your face. And
but
you probably go to sleep at 1 or 2 in the morning, but you always seem to wake up at that damn time.
Time I break the chains on our assignments. I was pouring all of my emotion in my music. And to beat one habit, you replace it, and it's true sheet. Thinking back to Fire Squad, Uncle Cole was right. I mean, the same rope you climb up on, they hang you with. The same rope I climbed up on, to my foundation, to my ruins. And I'm slowly thinking back on how I was stupid. I carried the same love, but I put it through all of my music. Turned to Robin Hood instead of playing Cupid. Now I'm,
he's recognizing where he went wrong, his mistakes. He's acknowledging it.
It sounds like he was too busy trying to, you know, cater to the hood. You know, as you're saying, Robin Hood, instead of being Cupid, probably means instead of focusing on his
trying
family
to be
and
a
his
tough
life,
guy. And,
probably stuck on that sort of mindset.
Yeah, but on the process of that,
he was
hurting his loved ones.
Yeah, probably putting them at risk in a sense too.
Music turned to Robin Hood instead of playing Cupid. Now I'm looking for our pictures and I'm out of sections. I was more loyal than a German shepherd. I never cheated on you once, but somehow I'm feeling worse than ever. You got me feeling all neglected. These emotions I rejected, so I turned myself to Henny and I'm feeling real different. Turned myself to Henny and I'm feeling real distant. Aye. And to my kids, I wish I kissed them more. Can't believe that they're gone. Aye. Cause I've been thinking we should take some time. I feel warm when I'm sipping. I think I'm slipping into deep.
probably warm when he's sipping, like it's like a temporary feeling, getting drunk and stuff doesn't last long.
Yeah, just, but you know, you always know, you know, that drinking either escalates a problem or it just, you forget about that problem just for that time until the morning you wake up, the problem's still there. The kids, I'm quite lost there. So they must be like separated. Just, that's what I was thinking of when you said that. The brothers that go through this kind of crap and then lose their family in the process. We know we have family like that too.
I guess you wouldn't, like with these boys, they never think it's going to happen until it happens, And then that's when the regret starts kicking in and stuff like that. But
And then the kids are stuck in the middle.
Yeah.
Oh, we feel you.
100%.
I love this guy, man. Yeah. Just
definitely.
It's not all about the bars.
Yeah.
It's portraying your feelings and stuff like that in music and using music to unleash it.
Yeah.
And also, it's an awareness to those with mental problems and fighting your demons. Mm. Like,
that song's deep, man.
I want to go hug him.
Yeah. Like, I'm a little bit lucky, about to tear up, I'm trying not to. Looking in too deep, eh? I feel tall when I'm tripping. I just need to find me some more reason. I've been drinking, food is on my mind. I've been thinking, we should take some time. I feel low when I'm sleeping. I think I'm slipping in too deep, eh? I feel tall when I'm tripping. I just need to find me some more treason. Big ups to this guy. Yeah. Big ups, man, bro.
Sharing your story. Wow.
Deeper than I ever thought it was gonna be.
Yeah,
usually when
last
I see,
one
yeah,
was deep, but this one's.
When I see titles with numbers like that, I usually know it's gonna be a deep song, but damn, this one really hit deep, man. Like, he really just, you know, showed a certain depth, you know, visual of what he's going through. He's really explaining and telling us a story. Like, we felt like before he was already giving us so much information about himself. This one, like, if he makes another track that really goes more in depth,
I think they can go any more depth on this.
I'd be really shocked if he
did. I mean, we've already got the visuals of it, of what he went through, and
So it does really link up to his last track, eh?
Yeah, I think
like
this is
take three. The ending, man. The ending. What do you think, Mama B? We've never come across an artist that's
really shared. Really intense in that way with fighting his demons and what he's gained but what he's lost in the process of it all.
Yeah. Sort of in a sense, like, you can't have everything at one time sort of thing. Yeah. Like, you gotta sacrifice some things and, you know. Damn, like how he said that, like she thought he was cheating, but you know, he didn't think that, like, you know, this hurt more than, you know, that. So many.
Right.
I'm just so shook, man. Like,
we started off happy and good.
Now I'm like, damn. Honestly, big ups to you, bro. Mad love. Just want to say thank you to those behind the scenes for really putting this together, and I'm guessing he really loved this clip. It really portrayed the story he was trying to tell, even how it was just him and in the screen, you know. Damn.
In the beginning.
Yeah. Everything about the clip was amazing, from the beat, how it switched up like 3 to 4 times, and then he started singing towards the end. I really liked the switch up. He really put effort into the song.
And he portrayed how, you know, you're fighting demons. Stuff like this, you spiral out of control, and it just... it just chucks you into depression.
Yeah.
And you just feel helpless and you can only like make mistake after mistake or stuff like that. It's what people don't understand. Easier said than done. Mm. Like, reach out, but really it's like you just need to pull them out.
Yeah.
100%. Like, I just want to pull them and grab them and hug them and go, we got you.
Yeah. Another thing is, because he feels like it's something he could have prevented, but he didn't at the time.
Mm.
Now he's really regretting it. Yeah.
We all learn from our mistakes.
Mm.
I mean, yeah, we lose some on the process, but no, we gotta learn. We gotta learn by our mistakes on our own.
Yeah.
And if some just can't seem to find their way back out of it, that's when we just need to grab them.
Grab them, yeah.
Mm.
We're definitely here for you, bro, if you need to talk, or just anyone in general.
Anybody,
anybody.
I know he's fighting, I know he's winning, because
he's expressing it.
Which you don't really hear
often from people.
People going through depression, they don't really like to share because they feel they're
burdening or anything.
You're burdening people, you don't really hear it.
But he's found love in, as he was saying, he's found love in, you know, expressing himself through music. And that's, you know, an awesome way to share your story. And that's sharing it to millions of people that could be listening to you, you know. So in a sense, you're opening to heaps of people that are willing to listen. And also people that are probably going through the same thing and they're like, I'm the only one, you know, in this situation. What can I do? And a lot of brothers will probably be in your situation right now, bro.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think we're going to rate this video. This video is too deep for us. I don't think, just with how shocked and gobsmacked and just, you know, just how speechless we are with this track. I think, and how he says it lyrically, just how he came about it. It was powerful, man.
How he says it, how he describes it, like...
He describes it in minimal words.
Yeah. Like, you guys are very... who have not gone through depression and suicide, you know. You guys are very lucky.
Mm.
You guys are very lucky. But also don't be ignorant of the fact that there are people
there.
There
are, just because you're not going through it, or people around you are not going through it, doesn't mean that there aren't people going through it. That goes for any situation, don't you know.
Mm. It doesn't mean that those going through it are loved less.
Mm.
It's just that
some
don't want
things
a burden
come,
and... they think differently, like think differently. We don't want a burden. We don't want to stress people out. Like, they got their kids, they got their family, they're working, stuff like that. It's just people think differently. Yeah. Big ups.
You got a speechless, man. Thank you again for sharing your story and really just going in depth with what's going on in your life.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah. But yeah, much love, stay safe, and see you guys in the next video. Bye.